So now I'm like paranoid, we better move, because if she like drives by. Yeah.
It's very hard to surprise my mom. I talk to her like 700 times a day. So it was hard not to talk to her because I didn't want to say too much. I'm so excited.
So is she just being dropped off?
My dad are on their way.
But she's picking me up to go to dinner.
Oh, what? You should be like, Mom, I got the kids with a babysitter. Come. You should have made me the babysitter. Oh, that would have been so good. Mom, come in. You want to see your new babysitter?
Yes, say that. When what? She comes, that you're babysitting tonight.
Do you want to say that?
Yeah, we can say that.
Do you want to say that
I'm babysitting? My mother-in-law's supposed to babysit, she thinks. So we could say you are instead.
Come in, because I need your opinion. My mother-in-law canceled, and I got this girl from the neighborhood to watch the kids, and I want you to.
What?
Hey, Dad.
We're almost there.
All right, listen, I have a problem. Rock's mom canceled, and I had my neighbor's daughter come watch the kids. So I want Mommy to come meet her and tell me if she thinks I should leave them with her.
I know,
I'm sorry.
You want us to take Jordan?
Just come in and see,
come inside,
yeah.
Mom.
All right,
love you.
Oh, my. This is better. This even makes me feel like, your mother-in-law canceled. Oh.
I knew my mom would have to come in and meet who it was right away.
I'll meet the babysitter. Oh, wait. That's them. Oh, that's them. Sorry.
Hi.
Diane, do you think I can handle Jordan?
What?
You gotta go to dinner, right? I gotta watch the grandchildren.
Can I watch
your grandchildren? Do you think I'm capable? Do you think I can watch your grandchildren?
Oh,
is that a yes?
What? Are you? Now, what is this?
I'm just in shock to see Teresa.
Wait, listen. Do you watch that show, Long Island Medium?
Yes.
So you know what happens when I knock on people's doors and they don't know that I'm coming? Do you know what that's called?
A shock.
Yes, it's called a knock and shock.
Are you okay?
I would have never believed it in a million years that this could happen to me.
Your girls set this whole thing up. So we're standing here talking, and then I said, how are you gonna get her to come in the house? I go, why don't you say your babysitter canceled? We just came up with this
that
right now.
Just happened.
Oh, they had a fight!
I said, I'm not leaving my babies with a stranger. I'll take them. We're gonna take them.
So that was perfect when I said, do you think it'll be safe to leave your grandchildren?
My daughter wanted me to come in to meet the new babysitter, but I was gonna be very polite, but I was gonna take them with me. I was not leaving my babies with a new babysitter.
So you're up for this?
Yes, absolutely.
Okay. Yeah. Well, thank you again for getting her here.
No problem.
Thank you so much. Very nice to meet you. And girls,
thank you for setting this up.
I am a big fan of Teresa. She's beautiful, she's spiritual, and I'm just honored to have this experience with her.
So have you ever been to a medium before?
Yes, years ago.
Oh, okay, good. The way that I read is spirit is gonna acknowledge things that are going on in your life now. They're gonna bring up and talk about things to help you release any burdens and guilt, any negative emotions that you might be carrying to help make tomorrow a little bit easier. Not easy, because after the loss of a loved one, life is never easy. But hopefully a little bit easier in knowing that they are still with us and just in a different way. So I am going to acknowledge you do have a lot of souls that are stepping forward. I don't know if all of them are going to get to speak, because what happened is there is a mother energy that stepped forward. So as your mom departed,
yes,
she makes me feel like she is the strongest person, the person that you want to hear from, and everyone else can go pound salt because she's here.
Very true.
Do you hear things in your house? Can you hear the souls walking in the house?
My mother is always around.
Because I keep hearing the slippers.
Oh.
And I...
Yeah. She had a pair of slippers in my home. She had a pair of slippers in my daughter's home. She had her slippers in every house because she came in and put her slippers on. And she's...
You can hear them.
Absolutely.
Validating that what you hear that reminds you of mom, know that there truly is her soul with you at that exact moment. She goes, and the best, Teresa, is when we're in our favorite store shopping and she talks to me like I'm there, Ma, should I buy this? Isn't this a good bargain? She goes, I am there. She goes, but no one else can see me.
This is right on. My relationship with my mom was very unique. She was my shopping buddy. She was my confidant. She was my best friend. She was the most wonderful, caring, loving woman. And it was hard losing her.
Your mom, she is hilarious. Because she's clicking around in her slippers. Mm-hmm. Then the next thing I know, she has me in front of her casket. And she has me fixing her hair. I'm changing her makeup. And she goes, Teresa, she goes, thank God. She goes, could you imagine? When Spirit acknowledges those things, it is whatever it is that we were so worried. Did I do the right thing? I wanted everything to be perfect. Everything to be the way that mom had it. So know that it is your mom's way of validating, thanking you for that, and more importantly, that it was fine.
It was so important for me to hear that my mom was pleased with how she looked at her wake, because my mother was meticulous. She was always dressed. I knew that was important, so I had to make sure I had all her favorites, her nail polish, her lipstick, her makeup, and to me, that was my mother validating that she was happy that I did that. And it was important to me to hear that.
Oh, so now is there also something about earrings?
Oh, she had these gorgeous mabe, pearl, and diamond earrings. And I loved them.
And she said to me, listen to me. When I'm gone, Marion gets them. My sister-in-law.
I told my mother, I said, Mom, I'll tell her I lost them.
Did you say that? Because she had me right lost.
The word lost, that was our joke. I said, Mom, who's gonna know after you die that they weren't meant for me, you know? I could have said we lost them. I lost them. My sister-in-law, they were meant for her, and she wears them and she looks beautiful in them, but these are the things that no one would ever, ever know.
Your mom also says, please know that I am not cold anymore, because she held up a knitted blanket and placed it to the side, validating that you took very good care of her. And I can see you like massaging her arms, her legs, and you know.
Her feet, I did all the time, yeah.
So know that she says, I want to thank you for all of that. She says, and I want to thank you for telling me that it was okay to let go. She goes, Teresa, I wanted to die days before. She goes, everyone would leave the room and then I'd go to die. She goes, and they would all come rushing back in the room. She says, so I would wait because I didn't want them to cry.
She made us leave. She made us leave and we came back.
So you know she wants to thank you for releasing her soul on her terms and knowing that she left when it was her soul's time to leave.
My mother passed away 3 years ago from cancer. What I needed to hear from my mom was that we did everything we could possibly do for her, and we all did the right thing by her. And Teresa validated that my mom said her goodbyes and she was ready to pass. It's very comforting to hear.
Your mom says, now did you move or did you just find boxes of her stuff?
Oh.
Because she goes, tell her that it's okay to let go of these items.
Unbelievable. I'm going through this now.
Okay. She says, I don't want it to be a burden.
Mm-hmm.
It's okay to kind of let go a little bit. That doesn't mean we forget.
I needed to hear this.
My mom has a home and we're starting to pack it up, but there's so much as far as boxes and photos and just going through everything. It's a very hard situation.
Your mom did an amazing job, and this is why I'm so proud of Spirit, on how they give us that gift of healing. So I want to thank you for giving me this amazing opportunity to channel the souls of your loved ones.